There's 248s news, there's new photo books coming out, and new members joining. I'm Mr. Josh Bucks, and this is the AKB48 Group News of the Week. Now, for those of you who haven't watched an episode before, I go in order of 48, graduated, 46, and a community section. So you can always know what section you're on the top right of the screen. So first up in the news is Stu48 and how their first single that I talked about a while ago actually has been delayed until January. And I mean, it kind of makes sense knowing that their boat isn't finished, which means they don't have an actual theater to play at. It kind of makes it a little difficult to actually release your single when you're not even set on a property yet. So from November all the way to January, it's a little bit of a 2-month push back, but as long as the song comes out good, I'm not going to complain that much. Again, it's a boat theme, so it might as well be a party theme, right? Because I mean, what else do you do on a boat? You don't just go around and just sleep all day. Next up is with Watanabe Mayu actually confirming when her graduation is going to happen. It will be at Saitama Super Arena October 31st of this year. And her last handshake event is actually at the 18th of November. So there's around 2 months left of Watanabe Mayu left in AKB48. I imagine after this she could go on to do great things. After all, she is very talented and can do many things. Totally not biased at all. Next up is about Suto Ririka or Riripon and about how she won't leave the show business. Now, even though she's going to graduate August 30th, she has said that she will go, I think it was Germany, and go study abroad. And I mean, if she wants to continue in the entertainment business, is she going to go there first, then get married, and then finally go back to the entertainment business? Or is she going to go over there, get married there, and do show business, like, back and forth in between? I don't know exactly how she's going to do that, but she has no plans to stop. And I mean, with all the craze she got from the news surrounding this, I imagine her popularity is pretty much higher than it's been recently. I mean, it's like they say, a good push or a bad push is still a push. So generally, it'll be good for her to actually do this and continue for her, especially since now she's as strong as she could be with different outlets wanting to talk to her about how it was in the group and if she was dating in the group and stuff like that. We'll just have to see how long that lasts though. Next up is about Nozawa Rena, who actually scared us a little bit on Twitter, saying that she had important news to tell us on Showroom, but then during Showroom, she actually told us the reason why she was gone is because she was in LA. Rena, you're in LA. You should have hit me up, we could have hung out. Or at least done a video. So yeah, she went to LA to study for a bit. That's why she was missing from Showroom and missing from theater shows. So nothing really that hugely detrimental or anything happened. She was just gone to go studying, but now she's back. And yeah, good thing, right? And next up is a photo book that's going to come out, and that's Shimada Haruka. But she is not the only one releasing a photo book. There's gonna be a second photo book from someone else, and that's Kizaki Yuria, who's also graduating AKB. So Shimada Haruka is going to be in November, meanwhile Yuria is going to be in September. And both of them, you know, it's around the graduation, but it's before. That way they could get the full hype of everyone wanting to get it before they graduate. So it's always good to get more photo books. I think I'll probably get Yuria's. In fact, I already pre-ordered it. And I'm still on the edge about Haruka. If you guys think I should get it, leave a comment down below. Next up is about another group, but it's a little bit different, and that's because Sashihara runs this group, and that's Equal Love. Another reason why I want to mention this is because they released a music video, and it's actually pretty interesting to see. They do the whole, oh hey, you're no good at dancing, you better get better kind of thing in the beginning. And then, you know, they do the whole dancing with shoes in the water. It was kind of, like, it made me like sick a little. And if you're interested in that, you can go ahead and watch it down in the link below. And also, if you're interested in the single, that will also come out the 6th of September in A, B, and C formats, with A and B only having the DVD. And for all the news that I talk about and a little bit extra, you can see it down in the link below. Next up, we go to graduating members with someone opening up a YouTube channel. It seems like these graduating members are starting to see the opportunity in YouTube. And that person is Lovetan, who actually released her first video, which kind of looks like an introduction to herself and to the channel, what it's going to be about. So if you want to watch that, that will be in the link below. Hopefully she doesn't fall off the bandwagon like some other people have. Next up is Shimazaki Haruka, who's actually playing the saxophone for a Disney event. Now, I don't really remember her playing saxophone. Maybe you guys remember, and she was part of a TV show. If you guys know, please let me know when she played saxophone during a show while she was in AKB. I'd be interested to see that. But she did play some songs. She played It's a Small World After All, Under the Sea, and I think those are the only two. There's probably like one more, but I'm forgetting it. But I thought it was funny how everyone else is like super high energy, you know, they're dancing over there, and she's over there just standing still playing the saxophone. I thought that was very her characteristic. And next up is a little interesting thing about a graduating member, and that's Myla Atsuko, the famous A-chan, who actually told people to go and support Keiaki Zaka 46. On her radio show, she mentioned how Tetchi was absent during the shows, and that probably like reminded her of the struggle she went through for being center, and just tells everyone to go support them. And also she mentioned that her favorite song was Futari Saison. Nice pick. Next up, let's go to the 46 side. We're gonna start with Nogi Zaka now. Even though they didn't earn 1 million in the first week's sale, they got 880,000. They did earn 10 million in overall sales, and it's not even like barely 10 million. It's like 10,500,000. So with all these singles mashed together, it's 10 million. That's pretty high up there in the charts, even just going to general artists. A lot of artists don't even go that high in their overall scores. So, I mean, this is great for them. Next goal is 1 million in 1 week. Next goal after that is 1 million in 1 day. Let's see how that goes. Maybe they should like include a little bit more bonuses in their CDs for those bump in sales. There's also new commercials for Nogi Zaka in a bourbon commercial, which they've been in before. I think this time they just jump around with the candies. And there's also a new Baitoru commercial, which actually has two editions, one with the lead members and the other one with the lead members with third gen. So you can go ahead and check that out in the link below. And it's pretty fun overall. They step on those weird things like that are in malls in America where you step on it and it affects the image under it. I don't know how it works, but they're over there playing in it. And next up is with Keiaki Zaka 46, who actually has gotten new members for the second wave, I won't call them second gen, of the Hiragana Keiaki Zaka. And out of 15,000 candidates, there were a couple members who shown in showroom, which I talked about last week. And out of those 15,000 people who applied, 9 people got in. It was originally 10, I think, but one dropped out last second. I don't know if it's like a whole Neru situation, but there are 9 people who dropped by, and the ones I mentioned last week of number 11 and 12 actually did get in, so that's good news for me. But the ones that are in are number 3, 5, 7, 11, 12, not 14 anymore, 15, 16, with the lowest age of 14 and the highest age of 19. So the mid-range is around 17, because there's a lot of 18-year-olds and there's a lot of 15-year-old, so I'd say like 17, it's around there, that's like the mid-age. And someone I should probably mention is number 18, who got really popular in showroom and even got a lot of Tokyo Towers thrown at her. So there might be some things to expect from her. I think an interview was shown where she was being interviewed about what kind of guy she likes, and she's like, oh, I never dated anyone before, and I think that boosted her popularity a little. But that could be because of that, or it could be just because she was very natural in her speech and she's also super cute, so that could also affect it. But yeah, let me know what number you guys were rooting for down in the comments below. I'm actually interested to see if the numbers you were hoping to get in actually got in. Like, I know people were rooting for number 1 and number 10 off the top of my head and didn't get in, so that sucks for them because my number 11 and 12 got in. So yeah, let me know down below. And last bit of news is Imaizumi Yui, who looks like she will come back pretty soon. She recently released a super long interview and solo gravure session on BLT Graph, not Bacon, Lettuce, Tomato, it's the magazine. And she says she's ready to come back and meet all her fans, meet the members, and do all the thing again. She even cut her hair and everything, cut her bangs like really short. I don't know if I like it. If you guys have been following my Twitter, you've been seeing all the retweets I've been doing, and you can go ahead and check that out at my Twitter, or you can actually go follow the actual guy, which will take us down to the community section of Too Much Idea, who actually was live tweeting the showroom streams from the Hiragana Keiaki Zaka, and also doing a bit of translating with the new magazine that came out for Imaizumi Yui. And Too Much Idea has also translated other stuff that Keiaki Zaka has been in, kind of like that flower thing that happened that one of my followers actually helped translate, so you can go ahead and check them out too. So go ahead, go follow them, go see all the cool stuff that they translated, you know, just go ahead and give them love. I mean, come on. But it's thanks to translators like them that give us the opportunity to learn more and enjoy more of what we love. So don't forget to thank your translators and give them credit. So that'll do it for this week. You can go ahead and subscribe to keep up to date with this news. And also pretty soon I'll upload that variety video that I need to upload. I didn't upload it yesterday or the day before. I haven't been feeling too good, so that'll come out sooner rather than later. It won't take like until next week. I'll probably upload it in the weekend if I get the chance. But if you want to see when that goes up, you can subscribe. You can also like this video, go comment, and generally just go check out like even the people on my featured channels. They're all super cool. I want to thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to leave those comments and follow me on Twitter and such. Again, thank you for watching.